Guys, do subscribe the Gate Hunt and press the bell icon to receive notifications on latest jobs updates, Gate talks and video lectures on Gate and IES.
Hello guys, welcome to this 15th lecture of ICT for GS for IES. So in the last lecture, we were studying about various storage technologies. So there is one more storage technology, which is the latest one. So we will discuss about this storage technology, and then we will move on to the various computing technologies. So this latest storage technology is an optical storage technology, which is known as hollow store or hollow storage or holographic storage. So it is a computer storage that uses laser beams to store computer generated data in 3D form. So the data is stored in 3D form in hollow store. So we can say that hollow store is a storage technology in which we use laser beams to read and write the data. So as it is an optical storage device, hence it is using laser beam to read and write the data. So if I want to store some data, I use laser beam, and if I want to retrieve it, then also I use laser beam. So guys, main goal of this hollow store is that in a small or little space, we should be able to store large or huge amount of data. So example of where we are using this hollow store is credit cards offered by various banks. So if you consider HDFC Titanium credit card or ICICI credit card, behind those credit cards you can see this hollow store or hologram in which the entire information of that card holder is saved. So it seems like it is a 3D image in a small space, but in that the total data of the user is stored. So guys, this hollow store leads the future to maintain storage capacity in terms of TB, where TB stands for terabyte. So guys, till now we have devices having capacity in terms of GB only, but after the overall development of hollow store, all earlier storage devices will get replaced by it because it provides a huge capacity in minimum space. So guys, based on this latest storage device, a question was asked in IES 2017. So the question says, let's consider the following statements regarding hollow store. So the first statement is, it is a device that reads, writes the data in an optical form. And the second one is, it is a computer storage device and it refers to institutions where holography is taught. So the question is, which one of the above statements are correct? So guys, if you see this first statement, it says that it is a device that reads and writes the data in an optical form. So as we have studied that in hollow store, we use laser beams to store computer generated data. So as we have studied in the earlier lectures that in optical storage devices also, we used to use the laser beam to store the computer generated data. So we can say that it is a device that reads and writes the data in an optical form. So the first statement is a correct statement. Moving on, the second statement is that it is a computer storage device. So it is also correct because it is storing data in 3D form. So it is a computer storage device. Guys, moving on, the third statement is, it refers to institutions where holography is taught. Guys, as we have studied that this hollow store is not an institute, it is a computer storage device. So we can say that this third statement is the wrong one. So the first and second options are the correct one. So we can say that this option C is the correct option. So guys, till now we have seen various storage technologies. Now we will talk about various computing technologies. So using the storage technologies, we are able to save the data into the computer. Now after saving the data into the computer, what computer has to do? It has to do some computing according to the user instructions, that is according to the program. So that computation is of various types, like serial computing, which was used in earlier days. After that, we have parallel computing, and then the distributed computing. And after that, nowadays we have cloud computing. So now we are going to see these all types of computing one by one in detail. So the first computing technology which we are going to discuss now is the traditional computing or serial computing. So in earlier days, we were having computers with a single processor. Now in earlier days, the problem that has to be solved was divided into some instructions. So a single processor is executing the instructions in serial manner, that is one by one. So for example, let us say that I have one problem. So this problem used to be divided into small instructions. Let us say this is I1, instruction 1, instruction 2, instruction 3, and so on. And then each of these instructions is processed by using a processor, that is a CPU, one by one. So we can say in serial computing, only one instruction is executed by the processor at a time. So guys, from here we can say that the main disadvantage of this traditional computing is that it is not an efficient technology because the execution speed is very low. This is because that in serial computing only one instruction is being executed by the processor at a time. So it is not an efficient technology. So guys, to overcome this drawback of serial computing, we introduced parallel computing. Guys, talking about this parallel computing, it is also called as parallel processing. It is a form of computation that can carry multiple calculations parallelly. The problem to be solved is divided into discrete parts, and then each discrete part is further divided into series of instructions. So as we have seen, in case of serial computing, the problem was divided into a series of instructions. But here, first of all, the problem is being divided into discrete parts, and then each part is further divided into a series of instructions. So this is the basic difference between the serial computing and the parallel computing that you need to remember. Guys, moving on, the next point regarding the parallel computing is that these instructions are divided between multiple processors. So in case of serial computing, we saw that we were having only one processor, but here we are having multiple processors and the instructions are being divided among these processors. So therefore we can say that it is a useful technique to solve complex problems. So guys, we can say that the main advantage of parallel computing over serial computing is that in serial computing it used to take a large execution time, but here the problem is divided among multiple processors, so it saves time. So what happens here is, let us consider that this is the problem. Now this problem has been divided into three discrete parts, and then each part is further divided into a series of instructions. Let us say that this part 1 is divided into so many series of instructions, and then part 2 is also divided into so many series of instructions, and similarly the part 3. And then these instructions are solved by each different processor. That is, these set of instructions are solved by CPU 1, and these are solved by CPU 2, and these are solved by CPU 3. So CPU 1 executes instruction 1 of part 1. Similarly, CPU 2 executes instruction 1 of part 2. And this CPU 3 is executing the instruction 1 of part 3. Therefore, at a time, three instructions are being executed in case of parallel computing, whereas as we saw in case of serial computing, at a time only one instruction was being executed. So hence we can say that parallel computing saves time. Guys, moving on, the main disadvantages of this parallel computing are that since we are using a large number of processors, therefore the cost will be increased in case of parallel computing. And moreover, in case of parallel computing, the latency can be high, which means that let us consider that there is some information in this part 1 which is being executed by CPU 1. And this information is very important for CPU 2 to solve part 2. So this CPU 2 cannot execute this part 2 until this CPU 1 has finished executing this part 1. So hence we can say that in case of parallel computing, the latency can be high. So guys, till now we have talked about two types of computing technologies. Number first one was the serial computing, and the second one was the parallel computing. So now we will talk about the differences between this parallel computing and the third type of computing, that is distributing computing, so that indirectly we will be seeing the distributing computing also. So guys, the first point of this parallel computing is that it is a computation type in which multiple processors executes multiple tasks simultaneously, whereas This distributed computing is a computation type in which networked computers communicate and coordinate the work through message passing to achieve a common goal. That is, in case of distributed computing, there are multiple computers which are working together to solve a certain problem. Whereas in case of this parallel computing, there is only one computer consisting of multiple processors and trying to solve a problem. So that is the second point, that this parallel computing occurs on one computer, whereas the distributed computing occurs between multiple computers. Guys, moving on, in parallel computing, multiple processors performs processing. Whereas in case of distributed computing, multiple computers performs processing through message passing from one computer to another. Moving on, the fourth point regarding this parallel computing is that all processors share a single master clock for synchronization. So here they are using clock for synchronization. But in case of distributed computing, there is no clock. We are using synchronization algorithm. So synchronization algorithm are used to coordinate and communicate among the multiple computers in case of distributed computing. So guys, in case of parallel computing, computers have shared memory, whereas in case of distributed computing, each computer has its own memory. This parallel computing is used to increase the performance and is used for scientific computing, whereas this distributed computing is mainly used to share resources. So guys, this parallel computing is being used in science and technology field, whereas this distributed computing is nowadays being used by various social networking websites like Facebook and LinkedIn, etc. So guys, how this Facebook and LinkedIn are using distributed computing? As you know that Facebook is a social network used by multiple people to share their photos and videos. So all the images and videos shared by millions of people are saved using this distributing computing concept. So alright guys, today we talked about various computing technologies, in which first of all we talked about serial computing, then we talked about parallel computing, and then we talked about distributed computing. So in the next lecture we will talk about the fourth type of computing technology, that is cloud computing.
Guys, do hit the like button and do subscribe the Gate Hunt and press the bell icon to receive notifications on latest jobs updates, Gate talks and video lectures on Gate and IES.